Welcome to Team Amazion's show, Speak Nerdy to Me, for the week of November 16th. My name is Anne Campia, one half of Team Amazion, and joining me to my right is the lovely Kaori Take.
Hello, everybody.
And unfortunately, we do not have Wakame joining us today. I thought she was going to be a special guest. She is a little bit busy, but we will have her on next week, I promise.
She's making the big bucks, Wakame.
Wakame got plans tonight, and we don't. That's how sad. We got an Arrow after show to do, but thank you so much for joining us. We're actually going to do some unconventional topics this week, and I will apologize ahead of time as I will look at the screen just to pull some information up and all that good stuff. But I have been in an offsite with my company for the last 2 days. It's been hectic, and Kaori has been nice enough to just say, let's just shoot the shit for tonight's episode. So
yeah, well, I love shooting shit with you all the time, all damn day, you know?
Thank you.
Unfortunately,
we are not as structured as we are, but maybe this will be the best show we've ever done. So I want to start off with movie news, and I'm just looking up right now to see who won this weekend. Do you have any idea who won the box office this weekend?
I'm thinking it was Big Hero 6.
Okay, so this changes things a little bit, because I'm looking at Box Office Mojo, and it looks like for the weekend actuals, Dumb and Dumber 2 made something over $36 million. Big Hero 6 with a little over $34 million. Am I reading that right?
Yep.
And Interstellar at third place with $28 million approximately. So any thoughts? Are you surprised that Dumb and Dumber is on top?
You know what? Not that surprised, because everyone was so amped and excited about having this movie come out. But it isn't getting very good reviews, sadly. And that kind of shows I'm looking at the Tuesday box office as well, because suddenly Interstellar beat Dumb and Dumber 2. Mm. So the word of mouth isn't doing too hot when it comes to 2.
Have you seen Dumb and Dumber 2?
I have not yet. I really want to. I have not seen...
It's got a 25% on Rotten Tomatoes.
That's not too bad.
Hero 6 still at 89% fresh tomato, and Interstellar with 73%. So, look, I saw Dumb and Dumber 2.
Mm-hmm.
And I will say, as a fan of the original, obviously you and I both talked about how big of fans we are, and I really want to take you to see that as soon as possible. It felt like a natural sequel to me.
Oh, good.
It really did, and it was just like... Being that much of a fan, having seen Dumb and Dumber like a million gazillion times, no joke, me and my best friend would walk home from school. We would pop in the VHS and watch it every day after school. Mm-hmm. That's how obsessed we were. I almost shed a tear seeing Jeff Daniels and Jim Carrey back on the screen together. And that first scene when they're together and they're in character, and I'm like... it was just a nice feeling. And sure, okay, I can see why it's a 25% on Rotten Tomatoes, but if you're a fan of the franchise, I do have a friend who doesn't want to see it just because he thinks it will ruin the taste of the first one.
Oh, you can't think like that.
I can't. Yeah, thank you, right?
Yeah.
I'm thinking, if you loved it so much, then see this one, because like we said last week, part of the reason that I really wanted to see it was that Jim Carrey and Jeff Daniels did this for the fans, you know. Mm-hmm. they got back together, they broke out of their busy schedules or whatever just to do this movie, obviously to be together again on screen as Harry and Lloyd, but they did it for us.
Yeah, I mean, like, what really comes in the way a lot of times is expectations. And if you go in there with little to low expectations, you can pretty much guarantee you'll have a little more fun than you expected if you take those expectations away.
Yeah.
That's all I'm saying. Like, I really liked Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, but I had exponentially low expectations for that particular movie.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, just go in and see it. Look, they pay homage to the first one, but I thought it was going to be the whole movie was going to be like Dumb and Dumber, the first one, and they're just trying to redo it.
Mm-hmm.
But like I said, it's a natural sequel. There's really funny jokes in there that are not anything that they took from the first one, but mm-hmm. they obviously do pay tribute to a lot of the great moments of the first one.
Yeah. So I really want to see it.
We'll talk about it once Corey's seen it, but if you guys have seen it, let us know what you thought.
Comment.
Leave. Have you seen Interstellar, Big Hero 6, some of those other ones that are currently at the top of the box office list? So let us know what you guys are out at the movies to see. Now, do we have any movie news?
There was a talk that I saw on the Geeks and Gamers page on Facebook. You guys are phenomenal and awesome, and we love you, and I'm so proud to be on that page. Where Seamus is interested in being Venom, playing Venom in a movie. Seamus from WWE. Yeah. I think that is the case. He's kind of bland on the WWE. I mean, he's a great wrestler, but I don't know. It's because the storyline they place him in is blah, but right. I just can't imagine him being Venom.
Does Venom talk a lot? Like, I'm not too familiar with the character is what I'm thinking. Like,
He doesn't talk very much to my knowledge. As you know, I'm not a huge comic book fan or anything, but I just can't see it. But then again, I mean, it's not like it's happening. Mm-hmm. It's just he's said, like, rumored to have been like, oh, yeah, I want to be Venom. I don't know if that's true either, but that was something I read, and I'm like, oh, that's interesting.
Skeptical about the you know, wrestlers that try to transition in acting. I mean, it's worked for a few, obviously, The Rock and Batista's doing okay.
Who we didn't think would do good.
Yeah.
Like, he did great.
Yeah. But then, you know, for others, like John Cena, not so much, so.
Yeah, they always try to put a lot of wrestlers into movies, and it just... I think The Miz with his Bounty Christmas or whatever. Why are they doing that? But anyway.
I don't know. But it's just like, that would be a very big role for Seamus to go into as his first debut, right?
Yeah.
I would want to see him in something like The Marine 10, you know, like just to get him to like, just to get him on screen, on the big screen in that type of role and then transition into.
Yeah.
I mean, Batista had how many roles before he became Drax, you know?
Yeah.
Like maybe two or three.
Not many, yeah.
But at least we saw him. On the big screen. Guardians of the Galaxy's soundtrack was free yesterday.
Oh my, why didn't you tell me?
Well, it was only in the Google Play Store.
Oh,
that's why.
And can't be a
I'm sorry.
BFF fail.
I can't control where they put it for free. But it was free yesterday, so if you guys downloaded the soundtrack, I thought that was a really cool giveaway.
That is awesome.
For Android users or if you have the Google Play Store. So I thought that was really cool. I hope everyone's listening to it today. I'm seeing that the Cinderella trailer dropped.
I have not seen it.
I have not seen it either.
I think John Campia tweeted that it was awesome. So let's go with that.
I'm just kidding. Disney. Disney is on a streak. So
yeah, I mean, I can't say anything bad about Disney. I'm excited because I get to go there this weekend.
Yay!
Okay.
All right. Well, let's move on to TV news.
Let's talk real quick about this. I heard about the Game of Thrones, the movie that they're talking about that might happen, a Game of Thrones movie.
Really?
I didn't really read into detail about it. I've just been reading titles and headlines, and I'm thinking, why is that necessary, dude? Like, it's an extensive book. It has so many things going on, and we're trickling into TV.
Mm-hmm.
Why do we need a movie when it's so extensive on TV as well?
Yeah, and TV is... basically, you know, how many episodes do they have in a season? Like 12 or 10 or something?
Yeah, they don't have a lot. They have like
10 mini movies.
Still,
yeah, it's movie quality TV.
I mean, they have TV. Yeah. I mean, HBO spends a lot on it. And you think about it, and we've got Game of Thrones, and then we have the Game of Thrones video game coming out. Why would we need a movie?
Yeah, I think that's too much. And do they even have material? Because aren't they getting to the end of where the books are at this point in time?
Yeah, they're catching up.
So really, what would the movie be? Mm-hmm. Would it be a spinoff of what has already been on TV?
Yeah.
Yeah, who knows?
I don't know. I mean, they might have been talking about it, but I didn't read. I just read the headlines again, so.
Again, it's probably this. Like, where can we continue to milk the cow, right?
True.
Coming out this weekend, Hunger Games.
Yes, you saw it.
I did.
Can you tell me how good it was without spoiling it?
Yeah, I'll give you a rating.
Okay.
Fortunate to go to the premiere. Awesome time.
And you looked beautiful. She looked gorgeous. Go to her Instagram.
I would give it a 7.5.
Oh, that's not that good, girl. I expected more from Mockingjay Part 1.
I think I gave it an 8.
Oh, okay, that's better.
Thank you. Yeah, I did give it an 8.
Okay.
I was thinking of something else. I gave Dumb and Dumber 2 a 7.5 out of 10. Hunger Games, Mockingjay Part 1, an 8. Having read the books, solid. There's a natural stopping point. I'm sure you could figure it out. You've read the books too. And Philip Seymour Hoffman.
Yes.
Jesus.
Did they do a good job with that?
Great. Okay. I mean, I think he finished this film. It's in the part two that he passed away.
Okay.
So I'm not sure how they're going to write around that or figure or edit around that, but he was excellent in this. And what's her name?
What? Jennifer Lawrence?
President Snow. Why do I keep forgetting her name? We're on IMDb, so I will know. Julianne Moore, is it?
Julianne Moore, yes.
Yeah, she's great. Or President Coin, I'm sorry. President Coin.
I was like, no.
She's great, too. Just a lot of good acting in this. And then I will say this without giving it away, anything away. They do such a wonderful job of establishing the districts
okay.
in this film. Better than I've seen in any of the films. Yeah, you really feel what each district is about and what they're going through as a repercussion of the last film.
Okay.
So there it is.
I need to watch it.
Yes. I can't wait for all of you to see it. I'm sure we will talk about it next week.
Yes, we will. I will go see it this weekend.
But what is opening against it? Is there anything opening against it?
Nothing worth talking about. No,
oh, yeah, there is. The Theory of Everything is actually opening.
Yes, Theory of Everything.
Yeah, the one, the...
I've got to be in a mood to watch
talking,
that movie.
Yeah, I know.
You know?
Hearing great things about that, too.
Yeah.
That actually might come out with better ratings than Mockingjay.
Probably will.
At the end of the weekend, but... yeah.
Okay, let's talk TV.
And Foxcatcher, I know, was released last week, but I wonder if it's a wide release this weekend.
I don't know yet, but that's probably the reason why it didn't get so much revenue, because it's not wide released.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I'm hearing great things about that, too.
Yeah.
So, TV.
All right, TV. Sailor Moon Crystal was awesome. Episode 10 came out, and I really want you to get into this so we can just, like, dress up and be Sailor Scouts together.
I need to, like...
It's so good. It's my favorite.
Maybe during Thanksgiving break.
Oh,
that
yes.
might be a good time to catch up.
Yeah, and you can watch it for free on Crunchyroll.com.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
So, she does an after show?
Yes.
This thing?
But I love Please Sailor Moon.
Check it out. And chat with her there, and I will try my best to catch up in the next few days.
And Downton Abbey, I need to catch up.
I got plans for Downton, actually.
Oh, do you?
You know what I'm going to do?
What?
I'm going to download all of them.
Could I come over? Can we have a marathon?
We should. We should try to figure this out, because my plan was, if I don't get to them before Christmas break, I'm taking those suckers with me to Canada and watching them
in a row. We should have a marathon and be dressed up on your couch.
Yes. But yeah. I feel like this is going to happen before I can do that. So, yes, we'll plan a date for that. So we will catch up with Downton, too. UK, obviously. Hasn't been released out here yet.
Yes.
What else?
Well,
we're doing Arrow tonight.
Arrow, Flash, but we'll talk about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we haven't seen the Flash yet, unfortunately.
Yeah.
But we're doing Arrow tonight, so catch our after show on thestream.tv.
Have we talked to you, these folks, beautiful people, since we talked with Steven? Or was that last week?
That was last week.
Holy shit. So, yeah, thank you everyone for joined us, though.
But we did talk about it, didn't we?
Did we?
We said that he was amazing, that he's, like, cool. And I
can't remember now.
Could see him
Time
naked
flies.
On the beach or something.
So crazy.
I remember thinking about him naked on the beach and talking about
I feel like that's... Are you sure that wasn't Zac Efron?
Okay, see, now we talked about Zac Efron and the many looks of Zac Efron.
Not over it yet.
Not over it.
TV, I haven't seen anything, to be honest with you. We've been crazy busy.
Yeah, we've been, this is why this is our slot. We just still want to provide a show for us mm-hmm. and then you guys.
Let's go to, I thought of something cool, and maybe this might not be the best time to introduce this topic, but we always do hate of the week, right?
Yeah.
I thought, why don't we do something that we love of the week?
Wakame. All the time. All day.
Shadow and Lily.
I will say something that I love. I love it when a guy plans something out for you.
Good shit.
Like, when That's you go one. On a date and you, for the first time ever, the guy's not like, what do you want to go do? What do you want to go do? And, like, he's just like, I'll pick you up. And he just, like, has the whole thing rolling. Huge turn on.
It's like Ray Palmer.
Yeah.
On Arrow.
It is. It's like, oh, crap, this guy really knows how to. I'm just saying.
Good shit.
Yeah.
Okay. I was going to say... My love of the week is you. No, she, it's
oh
always
gosh,
the love of the week.
It,
you know what? It is her. Because this girl got up in the morning this weekend, having had a few drinks the night before, uh-huh. but still joined me for an awesome sale of BCBG clothes, for people who know what that brand is. Stood in line with me for like an hour, shopped for an hour, stood in line again for another hour and a half. and it was amazing time, and we came out with beautiful stuff like what she's wearing right now. So I have to be thankful for people who are willing to do that kind of shit with
me. Oh, girl, I'm always on. Thanks for inviting me. I gotta thank you. This is now we're all like, oh,
I know.
Because I bought this awesome jacket, and she bought it too. So now we can like match.
Look out for the next Team Amazing photo shoot with this jacket. It's gonna happen.
Yes.
What do we do after hate?
FMK.
All right.
Why not?
FMK. For you.
Okay.
Jeff Daniels. Jim Carrey. Or Keanu Reeves.
Oh, God. I would kill Jim Carrey. I think he's crazy. I would fuck Jeff Daniels. And I would marry Keanu Reeves.
Yeah.
Okay.
He had.
Pomeranian, Chihuahuas, or Dachshunds?
Oh, come on. I would kill the Pomeranian. No, I'm just kidding. I was like, I would kill the Chihuahua.
Okay.
Can't stand them. I'm sorry if you guys have some. I would marry the Dachshund, of course. And I would... Oh, this is so weird. Fuck the Pomeranian. I think you're trying to get me back for that FMK I threw at you.
I really did. Right,
you know there. What? That's pretty good. That's actually pretty good. We'll talk about that video once it's up, but thank you for that. Food. I wanted to talk about this bacon... Oh, or should we talk about the fumpling?
Oh, my God.
Okay, so real quick, there's a bacon quesadilla that I saw. It was bacon mac and cheese where they made the, like, strips of bacon and made that the tortilla and then put the mac and cheese in the middle. But now that I'm thinking about it, the fumpling is a better topic.
Yeah, the fumpling was amazing.
Y'all know what a fumpling is?
All right, so if you know what a dumpling is and you love dumplings and you know what pho is, which is a Vietnamese beef noodle soup, well, there's a soup dumpling. And instead of, like, the typical stuffing in the soup dumpling, they put pho in it. So it's a fumpling. Oh, my.
Atlanta. I know.
In Brooklyn or somewhere in New York. I don't know why
somewhere
they don't come
on the
this.
East Coast.
It's BS. We need it here.
I don't know why we're not innovative with food out here.
I know.
And then by the time it gets out here, it's, like, some really watered-down generic version of it.
And then you got all these, like, East Coast snobs being like, oh, we have that in my
I know. Oh, the ramen burger. We're so over that. We're onto the cronut. Like, what?
Sorry.
Goodbye, East Coast viewers. I'm sorry. They just all left. We'll try to... I'll edit it so that maybe we can throw a picture of the fumpling up or put a link so that you guys can see what that is.
We'll put a link.
And moving on to video games. Anything?
Well, I've been playing... what have I been playing? I mean, Tales from the Borderlands is coming out. Or is it out? I forget. Telltale. I keep following them. You should follow them. And that's pretty much it. I don't have much to say because I've been so busy.
Yes,
you know.
I hate to say that. Like,
I'm sorry. It sucks.
I feel like this is the first time we're seeing each other in a little while too, and
it
like,
has
chatting.
Been.
So sorry, guys. We will definitely
next week.
Yeah,
it'll be top notch.
Yeah,
but we just really wanted to throw something for you guys
for sure. And lastly,
Zac Efron. You know what? Since Zac Efron isn't doing too hot, I would say let's do a crush of the week, male or female. Oh, here it is. It says Zac Efron. I would like to say Chris Hemsworth, sexiest man alive from People Magazine, official.
He is.
Yeah.
Over Chris Pratt?
Yeah. Isn't that crazy? Everyone thought, oh, Chris Pratt's a shoe-in.
Yeah. Because... You know what? Either way. Whatever. I'll take both of them in
and
a sandwich.
He said the sweetest thing, and they asked him, what do you think is the sexiest thing? And he said, my wife.
Oh, so cute.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure Chris would have said the same thing about Anna, too. So, like, either way, either of those guys would have been amazing.
Yeah. Good choices. See,
good choices.
Good reason why we killed Chris Evans.
Yeah. It's so true. For like the one or two females that watch this show, tell us if you would have killed Chris Evans too.
And all you one or two females, please tell your other female friends or your guy friends. Keep it going. A friend a day keeps us moving on and tell them, don't worry, this episode wasn't very good. They're better than the other ones. It's just, you know.
Did you just say this? And we're still recording the episode. All right. So we're about to cut off now because we actually have to run over to the stream and record our Arrow After Show. So thank you, everybody, for joining us. Kaori, where can people find you? They'd like to chat with you.
We're always awesome, by the way. You can find me at K-A-O-R-I-O-U-S at Kaorius on Twitter as well as Instagram. And go to our website, teamamasion.com, and throw us some topics at teamamasion@gmail.com as well.
Yeah, I would love to hear any suggestions you might have. We've been doing the show for quite some time now, so I mean,
yeah, we're officially like ideas 18 months or something.
Oh,
isn't that cute?
We should have an anniversary party.
We are. I'm gonna do that Comic-Con
with our 500 subscribers. We will have that by then, I promise.
Yeah.
Teamamasion.com, email us as well. Thank you so much for people who have sent questions and FMKs and all that good stuff, or just saying hello. And you can follow me at Ann Campia on Twitter, Instagram, all that good stuff. So catch us on the Arrow After Show. Catch Kaori on her Sailor Moon After Show and all the other amazing shows she does. And I guess we'll catch you next week. Are we doing a show for the holiday? We are, right?
Oh, it is a holiday.
Yeah,
we should. If all we can, we'll try.
It's American Thanksgiving, so we'll figure it out.
Oh, yeah.
But you'll see
I'll be here.
You'll see a show up next week at some point.
Yes, so. You will.
Catch you guys later.
Bye.